Really? You mean we're going on a holiday?
Yes, my little tree for Christmas.
For Christmas? Yes! Oh, I've been waiting ages for this. I've already packed.
What?
Yeah, well, I've been waiting ages for you to take me on a holiday.
Well, I did take you once on a space cruise liner with Sarah.
Well, yes, but I have the TARDIS to decorate.
Anyway, Sarah told me all about those killer robots, so I was quite glad I didn't go. There'll be nothing of that sort on this trip, so are you ready for a holiday of a lifetime?
Oh, I'm ready. Are you sure this is the right place?
Yes, probably just landed in the basement. Old girl's getting a bit shy.
Awkward, more like.
There, there, she doesn't mean that.
Yes, I did. Door's locked. You got your sonic screwdriver?
No, I've left it in the TARDIS.
What's the point in having one of them if you just leave it in the TARDIS all the time?
Sometimes I like to think things through without resorting to using the sonic. I'll nip back and get it.
No, I'll sort this.
Oh, hello there. I've got a reservation for two, for a week's holiday.
Yes, you are the final passengers.
Did that robot just say passengers?
Yes, a last minute deal on a space cruise liner. After the last time, well, hopefully lightning doesn't strike twice. Bag's just outside the blue box in the basement.
Yes, sir.
Cor, blimey, look at the size of that one.
Yes, it is a big one.
Well, are we going on then?
Yes, of course.
Well, where are we going then?
Only the best for you, my dear. There isn't a catch, is there?
What? Absolutely not. Doctor?
Just a bit of curiosity, really.
Doctor, explain.
Well, I've travelled around a lot and sometimes get quite well known. And, well, I got invited. So we're going on a cruise about you, with your most fanatical fans, then?
Yes. Rather marvellous, don't you think?
Oh, goodness, there was me thinking I had the robots to worry about.
Hello there, so lovely to meet you. I'll sign all your autographs later on.
Guess you're not as popular as you thought. Also, this doesn't much look like a cruise ship.
Please come this way. The show is about to start in your honour.
Show about me? Oh, wonderful.
Really happening. I'll be back in a moment, Doctor. Excuse me, my dear. Can I help you? Can I ask where all the other passengers are?
The passengers are here.
Where? I don't see anyone.
They're in the walls, under the floor, and all around you.
What do you mean by that? What do you mean by that? Do show us.
All the passengers are kept in suspended animation.
Not much of a holiday, but it keeps them fresh for when we need them. Doctor, it can't be.
Cyberman, why have you put all these other passengers in suspended animation? With their minds combined together, it would give us the greatest source of information on you and a supply of parts for cyber conversion.
Why do you need that?
Because once you have been upgraded to become the cyber planner, there will be nothing that can stop us. We have been waiting for you and manipulating events so you will arrive here.
Doctor, I know this is a silly question, but do these other passengers know we're here?
Yes, I'm afraid they do. The Cybermen are cruel. They keep their bodies almost in suspended animation, but their brains are still active.
Just like if you were to have an operation, they put you to sleep, but you could feel and hear everything, but just couldn't move your body.
Exactly right.
Then we need to save every one of them, no matter how dangerous it will be for us.
I knew there was a reason why I enjoyed travelling with you.
Zodine, the Puppet Master, the Adipose Evolving, all that was the Cybermen.
Yes. There are so many different versions of you throughout all time.
Just like you, ever evolving and upgrading.
Because of war in an alternative universe, this has opened up a crack in time, and we were able to see your entire life. With your followers' minds combined into the cybersphere, we were able to see all future defeats and victories.
And why are you keeping us alive and telling us all your plans?
Because you have been standing directly underneath a microbe, which is copying all of your memories as a backup in case you die while being converted.
You won't win, you never do!
See the cyber army awaiting activation.
Right, run!
Stop them. They must not get away.
I'm sorry, I can only offer you refreshments.
I have been waiting a long time. I can wait a little longer for you, Doctor.
Hello there. You won't mind if I just poke about a bit in your memory banks, would you?
No, it would be an absolute pleasure to help.
Thank you. Hold the green wire. Cynthia, plug the black wire into the box. This highly decorated box of tricks. Yes, let's see what happened to those passengers.
No, please leave me alone.
No.
Oh, Doctor, turn it off. Poor robot having to see that. I've just erased it from its memory banks. Right, turn it off now.
Doctor, we've met the Cybermen before, so we know how to defeat them.
Yes, we have. But what worries me are these are desperate Cybermen. Didn't you notice all the different types in there?
A bit like a jumble sale.
Exactly. They're upcycling, finding all the best parts of all the different types, and they will evolve once more. We've got to stop them, or they'll spread like a virus throughout the universe.
But how?
Together we'll find a solution, or there will be another massacre, and these poor souls will be upgraded.
Are you okay?
I am fine. I have no feelings.
Oh, you do, my dear. You do.
So what are we going to do? We can't let the Cybermen leave here.
We?
Yes, we. I'm not leaving your side, Doctor.
We need to play our cards right, and I will go and see the cyber controller. And you use your brilliant brain of yours to think of a way of stopping them, while I keep them busy.
What could I possibly do? The last time was just lucky.
Doctor, come back! Oh.
Would you like some refreshments?
Would you be able to help me with something?
How can I be of assistance to you?
Look, you're all robots, correct?
Yes.
Are your minds connected to each other right now?
Yes.
Then can you please help me to save the Doctor?
But the Cybermen have him.
Yes, but the Cybermen are half human, half robot. So there must be some programmed similarities between you both.
You want us to defeat the Cybermen from within?
Or just corrupt their programming for a few minutes?
That would take time.
Which we don't have. Oh, think. What else can I do as a backup? Robot?
Yes.
Is this ship heated?
The ship is heated from the steam that's created from cooling down the nuclear engines.
That could steam up the Cybermen's eyes. Just like when your glasses get steamed up and you can't see. Can you take me there?
Yes, follow me.
Cyber Controller, I wish to talk with you, and I agree to your terms.
Safe for you to go in there. The radiation steam would be too much for even your body.
Okay, I'll wait in here for you. Oh, now we're talking. Tin Man, we need to break this down into gold dust and then put this inside the steam pipes.
You will need to sign for this and pay for damage costs to the passenger who owns this cargo.
Oh, we don't have time for legal matters. If we don't stop the Cybermen, there'll be no more cruise lines
and you'll be on the scrap pile, or even worse, turned into a toaster or a fridge magnet.
Yes, overriding legal matters, calling for assistance to help with crushing the gold.
Doctor, you will become the next cyber planner. With your mind, you will be unstoppable.
Gold crushing completed.
Right, load it into the steam pipes and let the steam escape into the air supply. Just one more thing. Do you mind if I just have my last jelly baby before I never have the pleasure of eating a well-prepared meal again?
All is ready.
Right, go! Do you know I once met the great Zodine? Lovely lady, a little mad if you ask me. You'd get on well. Doctor, step into the conversion unit. No sense of occasion at all is there with you Cybermen. What is happening?
This has indicated there are traces of gold dust in the ship's ventilation system.
Then shut off the air supply.
The Cybermen are closing off the air supply.
Right, let them have it. All the steam we've got.
Systems failing. Systems failing.
What have you done, Doctor? Oh, me nothing. I've just given someone who's far more intelligent than me the time to work out how to stop your plans. You failed, Cyber Controller. One day, Doctor, you will be sorry for this. We will totally destroy you. But not today.
Would you like some tea?
Oh, what happened? Well, you've saved everyone from the Cybermen. All the passengers are fine. They have no memory of the Cybermen ever being in this ship. And all the robots are back to normal. Right, let's party then. Hey up there, Doctor. We're not late, are we? We thought we'd never get here in time. Did someone mention there were a party going on? Ooh, the price of biscuits have gone up again recently. Ooh. Did you enjoy your little holiday? Cool, blimey I did. Never partied so hard. Yes, you were out for a week after that macro soup. Oh, don't remind me. Fancy a fresh cup of Yorkshire tea? Yes, why not? Start as we mean to go on. Doctor, stopping the Cybermen and saving all them passengers won't affect the timelines, will it? The Cybermen will always be around. That's the trouble with having a time machine. You'll always meet them in whatever form they may take. And the passengers? They all have futures, which will of course ripple out across time and change things. But what about our timelines? Haven't they changed massively? With what, you saving me from the Daleks, and then you were meant to go on and fight the Phantom of the Opera? How did you know about that? Because I'm rather brilliant, that's why. You are, aren't you? No, the timelines will heal, and everything will find a different way around. As long as I can travel with you for the rest of me naturals, I'll be happy. Well, we haven't got long then, have we? You cheeky git, I'm not that old. No, but I am. Cynthia, did I ever tell you that you were my best friend? If you think by flattering me you're going to get an extra chocolate biscuit with your tea, then you're very mistaken.
It was worth a try.
Doctor, thank you for saving me. Cynthia, and thank you for being wonderful. So you saved both of us then, Doctor. Come along, Donna. No time for soppiness. We've adventures to go on. Doctor, there's no point in having a time machine if sometimes you can't go back and help out others in need. Now come along. If ever someone was in danger, and they heard that familiar yet comforting wheezing and groaning sound, they'd know everything was going to be all right. With a strong cup of Cynthia's best sweet tea and a tall tale from the Doctor. Legends say the Doctor and Cynthia never stopped travelling. They visited every world at least 3 times, saving millions of lives across time and space. Fighting monsters, evil dictators, power-mad aliens, and everything in between. Some stories never truly end, as the end only means the beginning of a brand new adventure. Where are we? Oh look, Doctor! Cake left unattended! Cake left unattended? It's lucky we got here. That's such an unspeakable crime. Well, I did wonder when you'd both come back for a visit. Sarah? How lovely to see you again. The legend also says in the small print that the stories you tell can affect others in ways that you'll never truly understand. Look up at the sky and you may spot a familiar blue box travelling past to its next destination. And just whisper these words. Thank you, Doctor.